we still have to go to the party. It's a mess. Wait, two moons. What the heck is that drawing? On the left of the
I hope Nathan
stairway.
Enjoys his last party. Chloe, we can go right to the cops. We have proof. Fuck the police. Rachel wanted us to find her. So we could get real justice. And revenge. The Prescotts have had this coming for 100 years, and nobody is gonna get in my way. Especially with your help. Right?
I'm with you to the end, Chloe. You know that.
Alright then. Let's get in there.
That eclipse.
You're right. Look at the outline.
I can't tell if they're different.
What is that?
There can't be two moons.
Jesus, Chloe, look up at the sky.
Possible.
Beautiful. I don't give a shit. The world is ending. Cool.
You're not listening. Something major is going down.
That's right. Nathan Prescott is going down.
Gotta talk about tunnel vision. There's literally two moons and she doesn't care.
Welcome to the end of the world, ladies. I'm glad you decided to escort me.
You look really good, Warren. Are you alright?
Really good.
Today?
More like drunk.
I really flipped out on Nathan. I just hate bullies. And Max, he's dangerous.
Yeah, I mean, he did
Where
have a
is
gun.
He?
So.
I didn't see him at the dorm again. I was held up in my room.
Dude, have you been drinking?
Well, if you consider half a beer drinking.
I was drunk.
Let's go, Max.
Half a beer.
Hey, hey. I know this is a bad time, but can I get one picture? I've been feeling like this might be actually the end of the world, so I want to have something for prosperity.
Well, I don't blame you, Warren.
I know. I'm a pain in the booty. Just one picture.
Action.
We've got no time for this shit. Come on, Max.
Sorry. I just wanted to feel like a normal student after this week's ultra-violence. I never hit anybody like that before. I was always the one getting my ass kicked.
Hey,
of course
you still
you are.
Need your expert help. If you see Nathan, text me immediately, okay? And do not let him see you.
He won't. I know how to be invisible here.
Not to me, Warren. Text soon.
So, I guess we're here to look for Nathan and also warn Victoria, right?
Okay, Chloe, where the hell are you?
I hate touching all these. Hey, Max. Welcome to the end of the world. Do you want me to check anything in?
No.
No thanks, Stella. Have you seen Nathan yet?
No, thank God. That boy creeps me out. Wait, some girl just asked about Nathan before you came in.
Yeah, Chloe.
What girl?
She had blue hair, dressed like a punk.
Yeah, of course.
I've seen her putting up those Rachel Amber posters. I'm stuck here, so I'm sorry I can't help you.
So why are you working at a Vortex Club party? I didn't think you wanted to be a member.
Screw that. I'm here for the job.
Who hired you?
Who hired you?
Mr. Jefferson asked me because he knows I don't have a lot of money, even with my job and scholarship. I'm not cool enough for this school.
Yes, you are, Stella. You're smart, honest, and you bust your ass for Blackwell. I hope everything turns out your way in the end.
Well, thank you, Max. I really appreciate that. Hey, your face looks so intense. Are you okay?
No, I'm actually not okay. I just need to find Nathan. and don't get too close if you see him.
Hell no. This is homework, not a party. I'll text you if I spy him. Good luck.
All right, we have a spy. Let's go.
Nathan and take him down.
You are.
Hi, Daniel.
That's what I like about
Max Warren. Max makes an entrance. I only came to the party because of you.
I'm glad to see you out and about.
Is that sure?
By the way, have you seen Nathan Prescott tonight?
No, I've been hanging with Brooke since I got here. Max, are you okay? Your face looks so serious.
It's nothing.
It's nothing. It's just a residue from all the Blackwell drama.
It seems like it never ends, huh?
This is where it's going to end. For Rachel's sake.
Well, if you want to hang out with Brooke and me, we're here for you.
Thanks, Daniel. I have to stay on my mission now. I hope you stay on yours and become a great artist.
Well, I'll be celebrating someday in a museum, Max. Adios.
Adios. All right, I don't want to talk to everybody, so let's get going.
Shall be.
Epic fail!
There it goes.
Win.
Alyssa, oh no. Why does it go all the way back? Right, whatever.
Alyssa, incoming! I'm on.
Archangel is stepped up every single time to protect me from the cruel world. Thank you again, Mystic Max.
Make sure you don't jump in the pool. You're gonna cause a tsunami.
I'm surprised to see you here.
I'm so glad I could warn you about all those sneak attacks.
You kinda are a superhero. You always choose to help me. It reminds me of the only poem I can quote when I arrive at
home. You need all the help you can get. Yeah, tell me why not.
I could use one moment of poetry right now.
Okay, but this is like poet karaoke, don't frizz. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference.
That was beautiful, Alyssa. It was exactly what I needed to hear.
Thanks for not cringing.
Sure.
And thanks for watching my back. Blackwell would be so much cooler if we all did that for everybody else. But you're a great start, Max.
I do what I can. Let's go. Bouncer. Speak.
Excuse me, but I'm going in.
Sorry, but this is the VIP section. Members only. Okay?
Sorry, but I'm on the list. Okay?
I know that Max Caulfield is not on any list for the Vortex Club. Nice try.
Take a
listen.
Look.
No, you listen. Courtney is supposed to be the VIP gatekeeper, not me. So please go.
What?
I need to find a way to enter this bullshit club.
God, are you mental? You can't come in.
What? But I was on the list, wasn't I? God damn it.
Music, okay?
How is there only one speaker with the music on? We can just rewind. How is all the music coming from this speaker? It's like a terrible sound. What about those two speakers up there? No sense, but whatever.
Nathan is the Vortex Club, so his ass has to be here tonight.
You get some work with my dad.
I know Victoria is next on Nathan's hit list.
Sorry, Max. Vortex Club members only.
Sorry, I'm on the guest list.
I'm taking you off. Go fuck yourself, Victoria. I don't have time for this bullshit. Real cute, Max. And after I apologized to you the other day.
Do you even have a clue what's going on at Blackwell? Kate Marsh tried to kill herself in front of you. And me. Everybody here.
That's not my fault, Max.
It kind
Don't
of
you
is.
Even try to blame me.
Don't blame.
I don't blame you, Victoria, but you know Kate had a church group and that she didn't party. So why did you send out that video?
Oh, God. I swear we weren't even going to do it. Then we had some wine and got stupid.
It's more than stupid.
Sure, blame it on the alcohol.
Mean. Hateful. Kate never did anything to you. And that didn't stop you from taking one last video of her on the roof.
I deleted that from my phone. Maybe I'm not her friend, but I didn't get off on Kate attempting suicide.
Sure,
I'm not evil, Max.
I believe you, Victoria. But I don't understand you.
That makes both of us, Max. I always feel like I have to overcompensate. For what, I have no clue. I'm only here to become a photographer, not president.
Sure, we'll see. You have talent.
You have talent.
We need to get on her good side.
You don't have to
warn her
push
about,
people out of the way.
To warn
you don't
her
understand.
About
My parents own a gallery. I know how this art game has to be played. It's brutal.
No, it's art. You don't have to play their way. Mr. Jefferson doesn't talk that way, and he's famous.
On point, Max. Thanks for admitting again that I have some talent. Not that I think I always do.
I don't either, but that's the choice you make.
Hard to believe, but I don't always make the best choices.
That's for sure.
Do you think it's like fate we're not supposed to be friends?
Why not?
Why the hell not? We're both into art and photography. We're both kind of weird and pretentious. If we hung out without attitude, we'd get along fine.
I almost asked you to hang out. You said my photos were Abaddon-esque. Then I remembered who I was.
You should have asked me. It would have been cool to compare photo notes.
Maybe we're too much alike.
You might be right.
Well,
yeah,
Max Caulfield, there's still time for you to get in the Vortex Club.
I actually hope so, Victoria.
Why do you say it like that?
Yeah, the dark room.
Victoria, listen to me. Your life is in serious danger. I know Nathan is your friend, but he is truly unstable and dangerous. He did throw the kid at that party so he could take her something. Dark.
What? Nice try, Max, but I don't believe you. And why would he do that?
That I don't know yet. But it was enough to make Kate want to die. And I think you're next.
Max, that is crazy. Nathan is like one of my best friends. Yes, he takes serious meds, but that's not his fault. His family treats him like a total freak just because he has little meltdowns.
They're not little anymore. They're deadly. I don't care if you hate me or not, but you have to believe me.
You could have been a major bitch to me when I got hit with that paint, and I deserved it. Max, I don't hate you. I actually think you're one of the coolest people at Blackwell.
Oh, yeah,
weird,
sure.
But cool. You
All
just
lies.
Don't know it yet. Maybe I'm jealous because you don't give a shit what anybody thinks, and I do. To be honest, Nathan has been freaking me out lately. He's not here, and I haven't seen him.
Just make sure you stay away from him. And stick close to your friends tonight.
okay?
I let you boss me around this one time. And I have other people I can go to for protection. Thanks for telling me this, Max.
All right, we got the word out.
If what you said is true,
we did what we had to do.
Then you be careful, too. I've got my own protection. Text me if you need anything.
I will. Thanks, Victoria.
Au revoir.
Is that all we had to do? I don't really remember. I guess, talk to Chloe.
Maybe there's hope yet for Victoria and me. I'm glad I warned her. Oh good, Chloe's here.
Oh, it says
she obviously didn't
find
Nathan.
I couldn't see because of the subtitles.
There you are. Chloe, Nathan isn't here. Nobody has seen him tonight.
He's definitely not upstairs or in the locker.
Jefferson.
Maybe he's hiding in his dorm.
Then let's bail. Nathan can't hide anymore.
So, you made it.
Oh, hey, Mr. Jefferson.
Are you both okay? You look like you're on a mission.
Oh,
yeah, we are.
I was just looking for Nathan.
Uh-huh. I didn't know you were pals with him. I haven't seen him since this afternoon.
Yeah, we're not really pals.
He seemed pretty upset. I think he's still quite upset over the whole Kate situation.
Yeah,
sure,
that
Kate.
Makes sense.
Let's talk later, Max. I have to announce the winner of the contest. I do wish you would have entered. You have to build up that resume and portfolio, but I know you will.
Thanks. I hope so.
Okay, excuse me. I'm almost on.
Let's get the hell out of here, Max.
Okay, everybody calm down. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate
so
it. But I don't want to get in the way of the party, but it's time to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes Contest. Before I do, I want to thank everybody who entered their photograph and everybody who thought about entering.
Mr. Jefferson! Sexy! You were so hot!
Now this
what the heck?
Is the
comments.
Most important step in being an artist. Sharing your work with the world. All of you represent Blackwell Academy. And everything our school stands for. As far as I'm concerned, you're all everyday heroes. The envelope, please. And the winner is...
Come on!
Oh my, what a shocker. Victoria Chase.
Of course.
Oh my God!
Victoria!
Thank you so much, Mr. Jefferson. It was your incredible photography that brought me to Blackwell, and I hope I can live up to your name and fame. I also want to thank all the students for being so dedicated in their pursuit. And I'd like to dedicate this prize
to
Kate Marsh.
Here we go, getting all the attention she can.
She is the real everyday hero of Blackwell, and I can't wait for her to come back. Thank you.
Victoria won. Big surprise. I can't believe she blackmailed Jefferson.
Yeah, she probably did blackmail him.
Yes, I can.
Who fucking cares? Rachel is still dead, and I want Nathan's punk ass now.
Me too. Let's go check out the dormitories.
Oh, Christ. Nathan just texted me. He says there won't be any evidence left after he's done.
What?
Shit. We have to go to the junkyard right now.
Is he gonna try to clean up his mess? Wait, but how does he know that we know? Wait, the second moon disappeared.
Stop stomping around, Chloe.
Right. Just get ready to use your rewind fast if Nathan tries to jump us.
This is kind of creepy. Walking through a junkyard at night. With a dead body in the ground and someone... That's like literally crazy looking for you.
You're gonna suffer, Nathan.
just some birds.
God, I want to fucking kill that little psycho.
Hey, I can't focus if you're yelling.
Hey, there's the lighthouse.
Please.
Again. I don't see anybody
Max,
here.
Please hurry.
Okay, calm down. Looks like she's still there.
Oh God, Max, look. She's still there.
Don't look, Chloe.
You know, they didn't try that hard to bury her. She's only like a foot down. Oh,
no.
Wait, what? What was that, Nathan?
Chloe! Look out!
What the fuck?
Oh. A headshot.
Chloe.
That's the end. Alright, that was another good episode. Only one more to go. We will be playing that one as well. Let's look at our choices. Accepted Chloe's request, 57, so the majority. Wow, you let Warren beat up Nathan, a perfect 50-50. Wow. Chloe wounded Frank, 26. 9% of people let Frank die. 60. So actually, most people kept rewinding, so nobody got hurt. All right. Victoria believed your warning. 10% didn't tell her anything. Okay. I saved the Blue Jay in the minority. I didn't disturb the bird's nest. Yeah. I got David's files in another way. Helped you find Nathan's room, alright. You motivated Daniel to attend the Vortex Club. I didn't leave a message on Warren's slate. Oh, I could have. I didn't even know. I figured out his PIN code. And I helped Alyssa, of course. Alright. Well, that wraps up this episode. So, thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed. I'll be seeing you guys in episode 5.